Hello and welcome back everyone, I'm Day-Glo Buffalo and this is Let's Play Tron 2.0. When we last left off, we had a fairly challenging sniping section followed by a boss fight. So that was certainly action-packed. And then we ended up here, wherever here is, in the company of Ino, who we have here right in front of us. And with Mithria calling to speak to us. Let's take her. Oh, yeah, that back there was where we were fighting that boss, but it doesn't seem to be in any immediate danger, so let's take a quick look at our setup because we leveled up. We're at version 5.0.8. So, as always, 1.5 points to health, 1 point to energy, and 1 point to weapon efficiency. That worked out pretty well for us so far, and I'm gonna stick with that. I'm just thinking about our memory slots here. I'd like to have Y-Amp available. So let's try and see which of these armor pieces gives us the least protection. This is 25%, this is 12, 9, and 8. So let's get rid of this, put in Y-Amp. Is there anything else we can stick in there? No, just the virus scan, which may or may not be useful, but yeah, I'd like to have Y-Amp available because it is often necessary to reach certain data bins or whatever, so it's always good to have handy. And let's see how things go. We might always change back if we need more armor. So let's save that. And talk to Ino.
What do you do here? I know everything. I'm looked upon as a great asset to this system.
Yeah, because he's
stranger,
called Ino.
You're
get
not
it?
From around here, are you?
No, I'm not. How can you tell? So I guess you can say I'm from the future. The system has been powered down for a long time.
I guess you can say I'm from the future. This system has been powered down for a long time.
The future? I know nothing of the future.
So we'll call you I don't know.
So do you know where the Tron legacy code is?
Not precisely, but I'll find it.
Okay. We need some energy. Well, let's talk to Mithria, see what she wants.
Connecting to IO grid.
Yes, I've detected another Saker. I'm not secure here. I must exit the power motor.
There isn't enough processing power to handle you on this system. The Seeker that followed me began to stall the second it came in.
Excuse me, I know I'm not equal to your superior intellect, but how about overclocking the system to increase the processing power?
Excellent idea.
I don't know if this system can handle it.
It's the only option.
Node deactivated.
All right.
Can you take me to the system's processor core?
Sorry, stranger. That's resource hog territory. Bunch of nasty programs with an insatiable appetite for processor calculations. I don't recommend going.
I don't have any choice.
Well, good luck to you then.
All right.
12-82, top of the line mainframe. Capable of 16-bit processing, full monochromatic display support, and a local storage of 128 megabytes. I challenge you to find a more robust system.
Yeah. Okay.
I know Tron retired from use soon after the network became a free system again. Unfortunately, his whereabouts remain unknown, even to me.
So can I speak now, or are you going to interrupt me?
I came this close to being acquired by the Master Control Program. If it weren't for Tron, I wouldn't know what I know, you know?
Uh-huh. Anyway, can I talk now? Sure you're not going to interrupt me again? So, we have to overclock the CPU in order to get Mithria to run here in a stable manner. And to do that, we have to battle the resource hogs. So, okay, switch back to the regular disk because we don't have any energy. And, Are you gonna open this door for me, or where am I supposed to go? Oh, maybe this is not where I came from. Oh no. I recognize this level.
Oh, and did I mention the tanks?
No, you didn't. But I remember the tanks. Tanks are read-only and indestructible. Enjoy thanks. Really. Yeah. This is a platforming and, you know, evade the tanks type of level. Because if the tanks shoot any of the things you stand on, they disappear, as they did over here. And we fall to our death, as we do now. And we have to make it all the way across. So yeah, get strapped in for another frustrating ride. Come on. Yeah, but this is useless. I can't go anywhere from here. No, I can't. Oh! I need to rethink my... No. I made it last time, though. See, there is a connecting platform. Wow, that was lucky. So let's save, since we're here. But there needs to be a connecting one in the middle there. Or no, we can maybe get around here. Alright, so where can we go from here? Yep. Okay, now this works. So let's grab this. And head back here. Stop shooting at me! Alright. Now we can regroup for a second. Okay, there's energy back there. There's health back here. Ooh, upgrade. So, I definitely want this guy. So, let's see. I don't really want to upgrade any of that stuff. Nothing really here either. So, this gives us 2 points more. This gives us 1 point more. 3, 3, and 5. So, yep, upgrade this one again. Alright. So, let's head back here again. I think there are subroutines up here somewhere. So, we don't really need health, but we definitely need energy and lots of it. Let's take a better look here. I don't see any program bins, but there is an upgrade node up there that I definitely want. Oh, here we go. Let's get this stuff. Alright, subject Tron Arcade Game, to Alan Bradley at N.com, from Kevin Flynn at N.com, date February 82. I have another video arcade game idea. Mind if I use the name of your security program? Promise I'll give you credit. Thanks in advance, Kevin Flynn, Senior Executive VP. So now, how do we get up there? Whoop. Ow. Ow. This is not a good place. Nope. Alright, let's get back down. Ow. And get ourselves killed. But at least now we figured out how to do it. So, I want to go over here, then over here. No, not like that. Up here. Ugh. No, I did it from here, didn't I? No! Are you enjoying this yet? All right. Okay. So we did that. Let's get some more health. Because we're about to leave this level. Fortunately, we're gonna leave the tanks behind us, so... Let's see. We have to get back out here. Unfortunately, we can't run any faster than this. And act- whoa. Okay, I thought I had to activate more than one button, but apparently that one button was plenty. Okay, well at least we got rid of the tanks. Oh, and now we're here. And this is the CPU core, isn't it? And these are the resource hogs. Actually, what I want is the sequencer. Now. So, what do I have to do to overclock the system? I want help files. I don't care about resource hog. Processor gate jumpers. Although this has never been done before, in theory it is possible to overclock the system by flipping the four processor gate jumpers. The gate jumpers are located on the top of the processor core and can only be reached using the center lift. Yeah, but what do they look like? No, they're probably down there in the middle. You have beta, so I don't want that. Okay, that's one, two, three, and four. Gate jumper's fully configured. Alright, so Aino wants to talk to us. And there's no more resource hogs showing up, so that's good. Okay. I think it's going to be quiet now for a moment, so we can talk to Aino. Access the IO node and receive Aino's message. Alright.
Connecting to IO grid.
Listen, stranger. I feel bad not extending a warmer reception, you being new to the EN-12-82 at all.
I appreciate the sentiment, Aino, but what I need is some help overclocking the system.
Overclocking? I know of the theory, but I've never seen it done.
I've made the adjustments, but nothing is happening.
Give me a few cycles to crunch some data. I know. There's an insufficient supply of power to the processor. Restore power to the processor's secondary relay stations.
Node deactivated.
Okay, so how do we do that? Activate the secondary power relay stations. Let's take a quick look at the help file. Relay stations, they're just regular buttons. You just have to find them. Okay, here we are. Oh, can't access that. So let's see.
I feel so irate.
The best thing about coming out of sleep mode is looking forward to going back into sleep mode.
I fully agree with that sentiment, Archie. 678. Permission that I can't access, and an email I can't access. I'm terribly concerned about the possibility of our digitizing technology, if we can get it working again, falling into the wrong hands. A hypothetical situation from Alan Bradley to Kevin Flynn. Just think about it, a user free to exist in the computer realm unchecked. It's a scary thought. It's a contingency we must prepare for, because I'll tell you, I'm starting to lose sleep over it. What are your thoughts on this, Kevin Flynn? Here's the power relay, isn't it? But apparently we can't access it. Not sure why. Because it doesn't seem to give any preferences for permissions. Well, here are resource hogs. Three of them. So, permission, yes, please. Subroutine beta. I have beta, so I don't need it. Nope. Let's move on and see what else we find. Okay. There's two resource points. Where'd the other one go? Oh. We don't need energy, but we do need an upgrade note. And let's see if we can access them. Or these bins, boy, there's a bunch of them. Nope. Nope. And also no. So we'll have to come back for them. Oh. No. I need a different permission to access that. So we'll be moving on. Is this maybe the permission we need? I saw the upgrade note that we need. Nothing up here. So let's first grab that permission. No! So let's grab the only thing. Ooh! This we can access it. Or maybe not. Didn't sound like anything happened. I think we're gonna have to go around here more than once. Oh, I heard a resource hog. I think I saw one. So, permission 8. The other one had permission 5, I believe, which we already have. Yep. So now what can we do? Ah! Okay, here we go. That did something. And this we can access. We don't need the sequencer, but we do need permission 6. All right. So, anything else? Already have that permission. Only 2 of them? Okay. All right, moving on. Oh, this one is already active. So, was there... Yep, there's an archive bin back here. That we still can't access. So, this part is already active. So let's check out the other two. This is not it. Another one? Okay. So, permission 5, we don't need. Cluster beta, yes please. Fuzzy signature, we don't need. And permission 7, yes. So. All right. Can we now access this email? Yes, we can. Subject, Tron upgrade status. To Kevin Flynn at N.com from Ellen Bradley at N.com. Date December 83. Flynn, I've got the new Tron update up and running, but it's far from being ready. It's impossible to actually verify, but my calculations indicate that my Tron update is unable to discern between authorized users and users gone rogue. It's a bug I'm trying to iron out. So far, it's been a real stumper. Ellen Bradley. And this, two more emails. Okay, subject. Hypothetical situation. To Kevin Flynn at N.com from Ellen Bradley at N.com. Date October 83. Man free to manipulate the computer from the inside. That is indeed a very unsettling scenario. I must admit that it's a little difficult for me to comprehend exactly the experience you had in the computer, but based on your account, your concerns are certainly justified. The first thing that comes to mind is Tron, possibly an upgrade to expand the program space properties, to include the monitoring of unauthorized user activity. I'll put together some projections, so this email should have come before the last one we read. Subject, Tron upgrade, to Alan Bradley at N.com, from Kevin Flynn at N.com, date October 83. Let's move ahead on the Tron upgrade project as we discussed. Kevin Flynn. So, why? Okay, so for some reason... No. Didn't want to grab the pants. Actually, what happened to that weapon we picked up at the end of the boss fight? I don't see it here. Yeah, I don't know why that was lit up. We didn't... No, we didn't get a new version. So far from it. Anyway. Yeah, we got what we needed from here, didn't we? Yes. So, let's grab some energy. And move on. Oh wait. We should be able to. Okay.
Warning. Core settings exceed default specifications.
Oh, this one's already active.
Unstable.
Is there anything here that we could pick up? Nope. But Aino wants to talk to us again. Ah, 7 we already have. So now we should be back to where we started. Okay, sequence. Oh, we already saw that. Hmm. We're not back to where we started, because I don't see a communications node here anywhere. Maybe it was somewhere else. In one of the other quadrants. Don't seem to be any more resource hogs, so that's positive. Permission 8 we already have. Oh, there's the IO node.
IO grid.
We've got activity here. The port is going live.
That must be Mithria. I'll be right there.
Stranger, there is something I want to ask you. The future. Are there programs like me?
What do you mean?
You know, programs from my era.
I'm sorry.
That's okay. I know.
All right, antiquated, ancient grid area.
Have you found the Tron legacy code yet?
No, but I've met an old program who seems to know everything about this system. Mithria, this is Ino. Ino, Mithria.
What a configuration.
Code alert.
I feel a light cycle part coming on, yep.
Foreign code detected in arena sector.
Here we go.
Activating game grid 1.
I see you now.
No, and I'm dead. Oh, come on! My shield break. No, missed it. Oh, did this guy box himself in? So all I have to do is wait him out and not crash.
Grid 1 victory goes to unknown racer. Grid 2 now online.
So we're moving on. Let's try for that shield break again. Okay.
Shield break!
Alright. So... carefully move through... Oh no! Oh! Pressed the wrong button there for a moment. That was lucky. No! Oh man. Oh, damn it.
Happy trails, program. Fragmented performance.
God, I hate these guys. Yeah, this is not frustrating at all.
Not even a fancy UI.
I'm trying to find a different approach.
Not too quick.
Unknown racer takes the win again. Grid 3 now online.
See, that's always the best way to do it. Just, you know, kind of try to hang back somewhere and see if the other guys will take themselves out. Oh! Go away! God damn tanks! And here we are in the third arena. Yep. Nice. Well, at least now they don't have that part in the middle that is all sped up, because that's really hard to control if you don't have computer-like reflexes, which I obviously do not. Did I box him in? Yeah, it certainly looks like it. So all I have to do is wait him out. Come on, hurry up and kill yourself. You're screwed anyway.
Unknown Racer claims the title of Grid Champion. Game Grid Exit Icon activated.
That was a pain in the ass. Which you hopefully didn't have to witness, because I'm most probably gonna edit this down just to the important bits, because otherwise it'll become totally unwatchable.
Connecting to IO Grid.
I know on the directory contains the Tron Legacy Code.
Meet us in the lower disk partition. There are two primary pipelines from your location. Unfortunately, both are heavily populated with resource hogs. Good luck, stranger.
Hurry, Jet. We'll be waiting for you.
User accessing IO Grid. Please stand by.
Operator, status.
Guest, my name is Jet Bradley. Contact my father, Alan Bradley, and tell him I'm in the computer. I know it sounds crazy, but it's an emergency.
Jet.
Node deactivated.
Okay, well, that was fun, wasn't it? So in the last episode we had a boss fight, and this episode we had some light cycle running, and the tanks, don't forget the tanks. But I think I'm gonna end this video here, so if you enjoyed it, please leave a like or a comment below, and I will see you in the next part. So until then, have a good one.